Our Super El Nino has come to an end. It's been over for about a month now. Sea surface temperatures in the tropical Pacific are near neutral, and the atmospheric variables that are associated with ENSO are also in a neutral condition. So where do we go from here? Well, most prediction models are calling for cooling and possible entry into weak La Nina by the middle and the end of this summer. And further, a strengthening of La Nina to at least weak La Nina conditions, maybe moderate, by the fall and winter. We have probabilities, according to the objective model consolidation, of about 65% for getting at least a weak La Nina by the beginning of the fall and continuing into the winter. The official NOAA IRI consensus probability forecast for La Nina is a little bit higher at 75%. And that's because that one weights the dynamical type of prediction model more heavily than the statistical models. The statistical models are not calling for much of a La Nina, just a borderline one. Dynamical ones are calling for a weak to moderate La Nina by the fall. So it looks like it's not going to be a super La Nina, but we really still don't know. There's a lot of uncertainty. But the consensus is that we will have one. And with that prediction comes the atmospheric and climate teleconnections associated with La Nina. And right now, our forecasts in that regard are calling for below average precipitation in southern Brazil and Uruguay by the fall. And also, right from the outset, a tendency toward above normal rainfall in Indonesia. Besides that, other than that, we don't have very much of a climate forecast so far. So it's a switcheroo from what we've been calling for the last year in association with the strong El Nino. So we have things to look forward to, and we'll see what develops as we go along.